Hello, everyone. Doing something a little bit different today. This doesn't come up too often, and I wanted to take the opportunity to film it. So we'll be a little bit unscripted today out on site. One of my clients is getting what's called a pre-drywall inspection. These are available for new construction clients. Not all of my clients get one, and there are a lot of different reasons why. Maybe you're buying a new construction home and the drywall is already up when you get the contract done. Or maybe it just costs a lot, you don't want to get one. So the house we're going to be taking a look at today, built by Pulte. They also build Sun City in the area here as well. They have a lot of different communities. They have more that are coming up in Bluffton as well. So first things first, you're going to hear some construction noise in the back. Very busy here, but this is what you're going to go ahead and see. See, the house is wrapped. We have the windows, doors. I'm going to go into the garage here. The inspector's going to take a look at your foundation. You got your main pour for the house, your patios in the front and rear. They're going to take a look for any cracks before the footing or the floors are put in. As you can see, we got our studs. The electrical has been put in. You got your natural gas coming in from the outside, and your main water shutoff is there. Electrical box is in. You can see you have your HVAC is in, all of your receptacles for lights and fans. And you can see those blue and red pipes, that's your plumbing, your water supply. Now this floor plan is called the Continental. Large floor plan. Right here is going to be the entry from the garage. We just cut through the studs here. You have an oversized garage, you'll have a closet here. This will overlook into your kitchen. One of the things I'm really pleased with what my clients did, they added these two windows, which is an upgrade on this home. You can see how much light that brings into this space as opposed to a big dark wall. They also added the corner fireplace here. And as part of the plumbing, your natural gas line is in. And one of the things they wanted to make sure, probably can't see it from this angle, but there is a natural gas line that they upgraded to get a gas line to the patio as well. So they can just hook their grill up to the natural gas and they don't need to be concerned about filling a propane tank. Upstairs, we have a nice open space here. This is great for kids. This is going to be your laundry room right in the center of the upstairs. Your washer and dryer on the second floor with all of the bedrooms. These are coming in a lot of new homes. This is your network connection box, so your modems and things will connect right here, and that will go to all the rooms that have those hookups. Now for the star of the show, like I said, this is the Continental floor plan. This is the master suite or the primary suite. You have a sitting area, or if you want to use that as an office. And then this goes into the master suite. So they have a beautiful stand-up shower. There will be tile, seamless glass, overhead shower head, double sinks. So, turn it back around. That's the preview of the status of the house now.
So one of the reasons why this inspection is so important, when you're the buyer on a new construction home, you are only really seeing the house twice. You're only allowed to see the house twice for most construction contracts before closing. That is assuming that you get to see the house pre-drywalled. So in this community, my buyer is doing their walkthrough on Wednesday. It's Monday today, and if we don't get the pre-drywall inspection done, it's basically up to her and me and whoever else is with us to find things that are wrong with the house. I'm not an expert on how homes are built, so I'm not the best at being like, that's wrong or that's wrong. I don't know what things cost to fix. And my clients, they don't work in construction either. So it would basically be the blind leading the blind through an inspection, where they pretty much sign off and say that it's fine and good to go. So the pre-drywall inspector is gonna come in, they'll take a look at all of your you know, stud work to make sure that that looks good before the drywall goes in. So after the inspection's done today, the builder's going to send over a report, I think he said tomorrow, and that will outline what he sees as something that potentially needs to be changed, or we need to understand why it's different. So he'll know as much as he can, and we'll bring that to the builder. If there's things that everyone agrees on is wrong, I have confidence in this builder specifically that they'll just get it fixed. So we just finished up the inspection. Gonna go ahead and just highlight some of the things that we looked at. We worked with Coastal Inspections here in Bluffton area, South Carolina. Very great folks to work with. He took me through the entire home, showed me what he was focused on, what things are common in this community versus other communities that this builder builds with versus other builders. So we're just gonna highlight a couple things before the report comes out. Overall, he said this home is pretty much on par with what he would expect in, you know, as good. Not a lot of notes for the builder, which is great. He was able to help me understand changes in construction from the 1980s to now, what some things might look like here in 2024 now versus 2021. Supply chains have had a lot to do with that. A couple of things that he pointed out. So we're looking at this stud here, just needs to be straightened up so the drywall will be straight. One of the things that he highlighted as a change in construction practices, not necessarily wrong, it's more of a preference. It's the use of what I guess these are called mud flaps. These are to help hold this wall down as opposed to your traditional bolt here. So this is what he would like to see more of as opposed to these. So we're gonna see what the builder thinks about these. All right, so it's been just over a week since we did the walkthrough on the house. The report came in the following day, pretty much at 8 a.m. We sent the report to the builder, and by the walkthrough on Wednesday with the client, some things were already addressed. So I'm just gonna take a quick second to cover some of the other things that I didn't cover in the walkthrough that are in the report. I'm not gonna show the actual report. You can see an example of the report on the website for the inspector, Coastal Inspections. I'll link them down in the description below. Like I said, I highly recommend to work with them. So as I mentioned during the walkthrough, one of the studs was out of line. It needed to be ground down or moved just a bit. So what you're seeing here is that stud is actually now flush with the frame there. There's these L-clips that connect the frame to the rafters, essentially. And these allow for the house to settle without causing huge cracks. So when these were first put in, some of them were not on center, some of them were just a little bit tight. So I went through, and this was yesterday, so within a week, the builder went back through and fixed all of them, the right on the center. They have a little bit of room to work. And here's just a couple pictures of what the fixed ones look like. The concrete pad for the air conditioning was just off by a couple feet. The builder let us know that that's just gonna be moved. They would have to move it. The construction manager that we're working with now is really diligent. As I was there yesterday even, I noticed this other stud that he marked as bowed. So I can tell that he's double checking the work of the contractors. So that wraps up our walkthrough of a pre-drywall inspection and what to expect at the pre-drywall stage. We covered the condition of the house, what is going to be there, what the inspector is going to look for. And then as a bonus, we got to see within a week how the builder here has made some of those fixes. If you're looking to build in the Lowcountry, I would love to help. My contact information is in the description below, and I look forward to hearing from you soon. Have a good day.